Hello and welcome to yet another exciting episode of the only technology show there is here in town, where we bring you what's trending in the technology world and also bring you anything there is to know about the tech world. I'm Brenda Kembabazi, but first, let's take you through what's making highlights tonight. On Innovate Tonight, we bring you an orphaned senior 4 dropout who has beaten all odds to create a shoe radio. And in WhatsApp, we put the new Nokia Lumia to a test after its promise to bring all social network updates in one place. And for our techie, it is Alvin Kato, an out-of-the-box techpreneur who has quite a number of successful apps to his name. And for our global tech, it's Apple's kickoff sales of its new large screen iPhones in New York. And for our security tip, our IT expert lets you know on how to block online tracking using privacy tools. This week, we bring you a senior 4 dropout and also an orphan as well who has beaten all odds to create what he calls a shoe radio using mere resources of his only pair of shoes plus a radio receiver. It also got me thinking, how can a brain this little make something that big? This is how it works. In 1895, a young Italian named Guglielmo Marconi invented what he called the wireless telegraph while experimenting in his parents' attic. He used radio waves to transmit Morse code, and the instrument he used became known as the radio. As time went on, more adjustments have been made to modify and suit the current-day radio. The story of Guglielmo Marconi is similar to Julius Atwini. Julius is a 17-year-old who dropped out of school 2 years ago after his senior 4 exams. He has modified what he calls a portable shoe radio, that is a radio receiver connected to his shoe.
In Uganda, we have shoes and radios, phone with radio, radios, but we don't have shoe with radio. The one, maybe if it is there, it could be, I don't know whether it is even in the world, but for me, I was trying to solve the problem of losing power every day on the phone. Once you are moving, assuming that you are going to get the radio from the phone, and yet we end up failing to get the radio due to the voltage of the phone.
Ordinarily, for one to listen to the radio, they would have to sit next to it to tune it to different stations or have it on their phone. But all this would be draining the battery life. Julius says he makes what he dreams of, so the shoe radio just came through a clear thought from the need to make a radio more portable. With a radio receiver that Julius got from a radio, he then cut out part of his shoe, fixed it there, and put a switch plus a tuning button which changes stations with the help of one's foot.
No, I was trying to make the portable radio which can be, which cannot be forgettable to anybody or any person, where the person is moving, be with radio or news anytime.
Using this radio shoe is quite simple. All that one has to do is plug in headsets, press the automatic switch, and then move while listening to the radio.
You just put on the shoe, then there is automatic switch where it automatically goes on, and you just plug in the earphones or headsets. But for me, I like headsets because earphones, they are dangerous sometimes. And with that shoe, there is no any conductive to our sensitive of the with the frequencies or waves transformation, because all the system is in the shoe, and the shoe is the bad conductor of electricity. So it is safe compared with radio of the phone and radio itself, not the other system of the radios.
It's made of a motherboard radio, resistor, as well as wires. According to Julius, the shoe radio when charged can run for 2 months without recharging. It's charged on electricity.
Since it is not wiring, it is hidden, it is not like of the phone, or it does not use the network and other system. Even there is good resistors which can step down the voltage. It takes almost like one month and a half, because I have been testing it. Now I am in a month without charging.
It's such kind of people like Julius that really inspire the meaning of technology and going an extra mile irrespective of the hardships and insufficient funding. All we can say is wish him luck and all the best, and we hope that he can get funding because he could be the next big name in the world of technology. Imagine all your social network updates in one place, as well as remote access to your phone even if it has been stolen. This is what smartphones promise. And in the following story, we put a test to the newly released Lumia phone. One of the worst nightmares for any smartphone owner is the loss of a phone. While the prohibitive cost of the smartphones is a factor that fuels this fear for individuals, the thought of having strange and unauthorized persons accessing the tons of private and confidential data on your phone is completely terrifying for businesses. The Nokia Lumia 930 is designed to dispel these fears, as Githori Gitahi, a product manager at Microsoft, explains.
If you work for a bank, you probably have a lot of very, very security-related information for customers, whether it's trade secrets for your business, they are on your phone in terms of emails, in terms of images, and that's a risk to your business. Windows Phone and Microsoft, why we say they're best for business, is it allows the IT manager a remote access to that device, and I can actually wipe that device remotely. I can even lock it remotely. So even if the phone is lost, I don't have the risk of my data being lost to, for example, a competitor who would know my trade secrets as a business and be able to use them to compete against.
He also highlighted Action Center as one of the key features and improvements in the Windows 8.1 software that is being rolled out. The Action Center is a solution designed to have all your social updates received in one central location.
So 8.1 brings a lot, over 200 new improvements. One of the main ones is Action Center that allows you very quick access to your notifications, so all in one place. So if you get a Twitter response, if you get a WhatsApp response, if you get someone likes your photo on Facebook or on Instagram, and that shows up in your Action Center instantly. So that makes using the phone very, very simple for you, because you don't have to go into every individual application to check what has someone said on Twitter, what has someone said on Instagram. It all comes to you on Action Center.
The Windows App Store was also highlighted that receives up to 500 new applications daily, and also highlighted a huge opportunity for Ugandan developers.
Even in Uganda, we've partnered with software developers. So you have, on a Windows Phone store, you can get the NSSF, Uganda application. You can get the PAL guide on our store as well. You can get the Jumia app, the City Life app as well. All relevant content for your market. And this will continue to partner with developers, software developers in your market, to make sure that even more applications that are relevant for Uganda continue to come to you.
Indeed, a number of Ugandan developers have taken advantage of the several Microsoft boot camps and trainings to develop award-winning applications, including BrainShare, Matibabu, MDEX, among others. The Nokia phones using the Windows platform have to contend with stiff competition from players like Samsung, Tecno, and Huawei, who use the Android operating system, and the highly rated iPhones that use Apple's operating system. With what we've seen in our apps, that shows that age doesn't matter when it comes to creating something. Probably Atwina Julius is an example to many of you out there. But first, let's take a short break.